गुड मॉर्निंग, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर योगेश पतिंगे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर जीएस कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स वर्धा। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द फर्स्ट लेक्चर फॉर बीकॉम फर्स्ट ईयर फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर फाइनेंशियल अकाउंटिंग। एक्चुअली आई एम होपिंग दैट वी आर गोइंग टू मीट इन क्लास रूम, देन वी विल हैव द व्हाट वी कैन से द रियल टाइम interaction, but due to this COVID-19 situation it is not possible. Okay, we have to cope with this situation and we have to start our syllabus. First of all, I welcome you to GS College of Commerce Vardha. This is your first lecture of financial accounting. If you see, I have a board. I wrote here the syllabus of financial accounting, and this side there is a question paper pattern. You are the students who came from board pattern, but when we discuss about or when we actually work in university pattern or examination which are the part of university, here we have to strictly cope with the syllabus and question paper pattern. Okay, same things happens with the board examination, but here this is the thing that we have to keep in mind for the entire semester, because we have to study, we have to work as per the question paper pattern, as per the university syllabus. So what happens in board examination, there is a restrictions of your medium, there are the restrictions of short answers, there are the restrictions of very less marks for the paragraph writing styles, etc., etc. But here there is everything is being streamlined, everything is being planned, and we have to act accordingly. There are four units. There will be first of all, I will write actually here. There will be 80 marks. Financial accounting paper will be of 80 marks. 20 marks will be of sessional, so 80 plus 20, the entire paper will be of 100 marks. So for this 80 marks, you will have 4 units, unit 1, unit 2, unit 3, unit 4. So 80 divided by 4, so each unit will generally cover 20 marks each, that we will discuss in question paper pattern also. So each unit have a weightage of 20 marks, uniform weightage of 20 marks. Now first we will discuss about unit first. Unit first is actually what we can say the basics of financial accounting. You are the students of commerce. You are actually prelim students of commerce. You know everything about what is financial accounting. Actually, I had interaction with you. Means if you are from GS College of Commerce, I already what we can say a frequent visitor to your class for taking a viva. So meaning, objectives, concepts, conventions, that we have to study in the first unit. Why we are going to study financial accounting, what are the concepts of financial accounting, what are the conventions of financial accounting, why financial accounting is important in comparison to cost accounting or management accounting, that we have to study in first unit. Along with that, we have to study accounting standards also. In our syllabus, there are accounting standards AS1 to AS10. AS stand for accounting standards. So accounting standard 1 to accounting standard 10, that is the actual part of our syllabus that we have to study. Each accounting standard has its own area of specialization. Each accounting standard is being framed, is being streamlined for a particular work pattern that we have to study. But actually it is actually a theoretical approach, means we don't have to see the problems of accounting standards. It's actually a theoretical approach, means what is accounting standard 1, means you have to just see and wind up in just one or two paragraphs what is accounting standard or what that accounting standard stands for. So we will start from AS1 to AS10. Moving to the next topic, we have to see the final accounts of sole traders. This part is actually, I think you had been well acknowledged to this part in your junior college, means in 11th or 12th, you had already solved the problems of sole traders. It's a one level higher. In that case, we have to see the final accounts. You know what is final accounts. You have to start from trading account, or if manufacturing account, then P&L account, and then balance sheet. That is a part of final accounts. Then we have to do the adjustments, and then dual effects. All those things that we are going to see is the part of final accounts of sole traders. So when I am writing, when I just wrote here the theory and numericals, it means that some part of this unit is related to theory, some part of this unit is related to numericals. Moving into the next unit is branch accounting. Previous year, unit number 2 was hire purchase. From this academic year, means 2020-2021, hire purchase is being replaced by branch accounting, excluding foreign branch. This branch accounting, we have to see the how the branches works, how their accounts are being kept, how the reconciliation is being done, how the amount is being transferred, how the amount is being credited, debited in one branch to another branch. That we have to see in branch accounting. Here also we have the approach of theory and numericals. Moving to unit number 3, we have to see the again the final accounts of cooperative societies. There are different types of cooperative societies. It can be cooperative housing society, it can be cooperative milk society, it can be urban cooperative society, it can be consumer welfare cooperative societies. Then we have to start with cooperative society. This unit will get started with cooperative society, different types of cooperative societies. Because we, in a theoretical approach, first we have to write out the rules, what are the rules, how much percentage of profit has to be transferred, how much percentage of the reserves has to be kept. That all thing we have to see in first theoretical theory, and then after we have to solve or start the problems of final accounts of cooperative societies. So when we are actually going to solve the problems of cooperative societies, it gets strictly as per the government rules, Maharashtra, because in this unit we have to see the cooperative societies from the angle of Maharashtra government. It is final accounts of Maharashtra cooperative societies or cooperative societies which are actually working in Maharashtra. Those rules has to be applicable for cooperative societies. So we have to keep in mind the different type of percentages for allocations, for reserves, and that has to be incorporated in our problems. So this is unit number 3, final accounts of cooperative societies. Moving to the last unit is a joint venture accounts. Actually, when let us see what the venture is. Venture can be anything, that if you want to start any type of work, start any type of project, a startup, that can be called as a venture. So the venture is being started, there's a more than one person involved that venture, that can be called as a joint venture accounts. So we have to see the problems of joint venture accounts in this unit number 4. Here also there is a theory and numericals. So I just give you a small introduction what units we have in the syllabus and what we have to do along with it, what will be our approach, how we have to prepare this syllabus, seeing or keeping in mind the examination pattern of university. So again, summarizing, first unit is about theoretical approach, mainly is accounting standards, final accounts of sole traders. Second unit is a new one this year, it's a branch accounting, excluding foreign branches, final accounts of cooperative societies is unit number 3, and joint venture accounts is unit number 4. So each unit will have a uniform weightage of 20 marks. 20 multiplied by 4 units, you will have 80 marks. So if someone is from Marathi medium, you have to keep in mind that this account is completely in English. Now moving to the next part is a question paper pattern. There will be 5 questions. The first 4 questions will be from units, individual units, separate units, and the last unit, the last question will be a mixed type, means it will have the questions from entire syllabus, that is unit 1st, 2nd, 3rd and 4th. If you see the question paper pattern, it is same for first 4 questions, and there will be a mixed one for question number 5. So moving to the question number 1, it will depend on the questions or syllabus of unit 1st. There will be three questions. First two question A, question A, question B, and there will be question number C, which will be in or for question number A and question number B. The max marks, maximum marks for question number 1 will be 16, 8, 8 or 16. So if you are comfortable with theory and somewhat problem, you can go for question number A, question number B. But if you are comfortable with the entire problem, then you will go for strictly for question number 1C for 16 marks. Same pattern follows for question number 2, unit 2. Question number 3, unit 3. Question number 4, unit 4. And we will move to the question number 5. This question number 5 is completely devoted for problems. So unit first, there is a problem. Unit second, there is a problem. Unit third, there is a problem. And unit number 4 also, there is a problem. But the marks are being slightly less here, as well, 4 marks. So these questions will be our short question answer type questions. So 16 plus 16 plus 16 plus 16 plus 16. So each question will have 16 marks. 16 multiplied by question 5 questions, so it will be 80 marks. 80 marks for university assessment and 20 marks for sessional assessment. So 80 plus 20, it will give total 100 marks, which will be actually the combination of 80 plus 20. So summarizing all this thing, here actually this is the basic of financial accounting, because you are the students of first year. So it is actually your journey, it's actually starting of your journey of financial accounting. In entire 3 years, you have to see 5 financial accounting papers, and this is the first one that we will actually start from the first unit. We are going to start from the next lecture. I hope you are comfortable with the syllabus and question paper pattern. In next lecture, we are going to start question number 1, unit number 1. Or in that unit number 1, we will start from the concepts and conventions, and we will wrap the theory in just one or two lectures, and then we will start the problems on sole traders. I hope you are actually comfortable with this syllabus and question paper pattern. We will meet in the next lecture for the theoretical approach of unit first. Till then, thank you.